In this episode, we're going to explore the legend of the Piasa Bird. Similar to other legends like the Jersey Devil, this is a local legend from the River Bend area of Illinois. It first dates back to 1673, when Father Jacques Marquette recorded his famous journey down this very river, the Mississippi. With his partner, Louis Joliet, he described the Piasa Bird as being a bird-like monster, painted high on the bluffs along the Mississippi River, where the city of Alton, Illinois, now stands. According to Marquette's travel log, the Piasa was large as a calf, with horns like a deer, red eyes, a beard like a tiger, and a face like a man. The body was covered with green, red, and black scales, and the tail was so long it passed around the body, over the head, and between its legs. The creature's name, however, came from the Illini Indians, Piasa meaning the bird that devours man. Today we're left with two versions of the story, one in which leaves the Piasa bird dead, and the other leaves him still stalking in local caverns and caves. Today, however, I'm going to go over the most widely told and popular version of the tale. This telling comes from a famous native chief named Atoga. His fame reached far beyond the Illini tribe, all the way to the Great Lakes. Atoga tells a tale of a creature that lived in these very caves for many moons. It was such a size that it could easily carry off full-grown deer in its talons. His taste, however, was that of human flesh. Hundreds of warriors attempted to destroy the Piasa, but failed. Whole villages were destroyed, and fear spread throughout the Illini tribe. At this point, Atoga separates himself from his men, and he begins to fast in solitude for an entire moon. And pardon me, guys, my astrology's really not up to par. I think that's a month. Hopefully someone can help me out in the comments section. Atoga prayed to the Great Spirit, and on the last night of his fast, the Great Spirit appeared to him in a dream. The Spirit instructed him to gather 20 of his best warriors and arm them with poison arrows and bows. The Spirit went on to reveal a location in which they could conceal these men, with the exception of one unlucky Indian who would be used as bait to draw out the Piasa bird. When the chief awoke that morning, he told the tribe of his dream and his intention to be the bait. The group of 20 men was quickly selected and assembled. And at this point, I'd imagine feeling a little bit more confident with Atoga willing to be the victim. Atoga placed himself in open view, and he soon saw the Piasa bird on top of the bluff, perched, eyeing his prey. Atoga began to chant the death song of a warrior. The Piasa took to the air and swooped down upon the chief. The Piasa had just reached his victim when every bow was sprung and every arrow sent sailing into the body of the beast. The Piasa bird uttered a fearful scream that echoed down the river and soon after died. Atoga was safe, and the tribe was saved. In commemoration of these events, the tribe painted this gigantic mural along the banks of the Mississippi River, at the site in which the Piasa bird was killed. This very mural was what Mr. Marquette stumbled upon during his expedition in 1673. Thanks for spending some time with us. Don't be shy with the comments, and please hit the like and subscribe button.